Hello to all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Sangeeta, and today we will solve the combined geoscientist examination of year 2021. This is paper 2 geology. Okay, so first question is the principle of uniformitarianism states that. So let's see who gave this principle. So James Hutton was the one who gave this principle. He said the present is the key to the past, which means that the processes that act on Earth's surface today are same as the processes that have acted on the Earth's surface in the past. It means वो ये बोल रहे हैं कि जो भी processes अभी Earth पे हो रहे हैं surface पे, वो एक past में भी वही processes हो चुके हैं, okay? तो यहाँ पे ये first option हो जाएगा. The same external and internal processes that we recognize today have been operating consistently throughout most of the earth history. Okay, which of the following is most widely accepted model of the evolutionary theories of solar system? So for this, the answer is of course nebular hypothesis is the one which is most widely accepted everywhere. Okay, next is the boundary between the Sial and Sima is called as. So it is the Conrad discontinuity, and we can see other discontinuity also. See, Conrad, it is between the upper as well as the lower crust, and after that lies the mantle, and after mantle lies the core. So between the lower crust and upper mantle lies the Mohawk. Rapiti is between the upper and lower mantle. Gutenberg between the lower mantle and outer core, and Lehman discontinuity between the outer and inner core. Okay. Next, the main cause of blowing wind across the Earth's surface is. So it is due to the heating of atmosphere, land and ocean accompanied by changes in air pressure. So we all know that why winds are flowing on the Earth's surface. It is due to the pressure difference. That's at some point of at some place there is high pressure and at some place there is low pressure. So you will say that okay, this option can also be correct, that wind blows from low pressure to high pressure area due to pressure difference. See, the pressure difference concept is correct, but they are saying that wind blows from low pressure to high pressure. So this is the wrong statement, because wind always flows from high pressure to low pressure. Okay, next is mega thrust earthquake are the most damaging and deadly of all earthquake. So these mega thrust are located at, so they are located at along the contact between subducting plate and overriding plate. It means where one plate is getting subducting and this plate which is not getting subducting is called as overriding plate. Okay, so they are saying that mega thrust earthquake, they usually occur in the convergent boundary condition or in the subduction condition, right? So here it is given about it, that how are earthquake related to the subduction zone. So subduction zone, where one oceanic thrust plate is getting under thrust beneath the another one. Okay, so here large earthquake occur, these are called as mega thrust. And if you want to read more about it, you can read this one. That is why I have given this image over here. Next is the term Soma refers to. So it is related to the volcanic activity, first of all. So the answer is, it is the rim of semi-destroyed old volcanic crater inside which another cone may rise by subsequent eruption. It means क्या हुआ कि पहले एक वो क्रेटर था बट वो डिस्ट्रॉय हो गया, तो उसकी एक रिम बन जाएगी और उसके अंदर ही एक दूसरा इरप्शन का कोन दिखाई देगा. लेट्स सी कैसा दिखता है वो. सी, this is the rim or boundary which was present earlier, and this is the another cone present in the center. Okay, so this is Soma and this is Vesuvius or Vesuvio. Next is mid oceanic ridges contain black smokers, which are, so they are the hydrothermal vent from where hot water laden with fine grained sulfide mineral jet out into the cold sea water. So this is the example for the black smoker. This is the hydrothermal vent which is present in the ocean, and from this we get sulfide minerals and other minerals. Okay, Next is trench roll back. So what is trench roll? So next is trench roll back. First, we will see how this trench roll back looks like. So it is basically the formation of back arc basin. Okay. See here. Here two oceanic plates are there. One is subducting, another in the asthenosphere, and here back arc will create. ठीक है. नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज रिफ्टिंग विल हैपन इन द बैक आर्क एंड ड्यूरिंग द रिफ्टिंग स्प्रेडिंग सेंटर विल बी क्रिएटेड एंड इन एंड अल्टीमेटली बैक आर्क बेसिन विल फॉर्म. ओके सी हियर न्यू आर्क इज फॉर्म्ड एंड दिस इज बैक आर्क बेसिन इन बिटवीन इट. सो इट इज द सबडक्शन ऑफ ओशियनिक प्लेट इन टू द एस्थिनोस्फेयर एंड बेंड टूवर्ड्स द आईलैंड आर्क. You can read this if you want to know more about it. Okay. See, I'm not reading this because it will ultimately take 30 minutes, around 30 to 40 minutes to complete this video. I don't want to make it this much longer. So that is why I'm leaving this part for you. You can read it if you want to. In glacier, the debris which is carried at the surface of ice is termed as. So we can solve this question based on our, you know, how much words we know. Like supra means something above, sub means at the base, and n means something in between, right? Here you can see this is the process of glacial transport going on. Glacial transport is given. So see, this is the movement going on the above, and n means it will be sandwiched between something above and below, and sub it will be lie at the base. Okay, so it is written same over here that it is then transported on the surface of the glacier. It will be supraglacial debris buried within, it will be n glacial, and material which is found at the base, it will be subglacial. So during the process of sand transport by the aeolian, mean by wind action, the mechanical wear and tear of the sand particle among themselves is known as. So here we will get some concept of abrasion as well as other. See, material is eroded by wind either through the abrasion or deflection. Okay, so abrasion, it is the impact of saltating sand grains on an object. See here, due to abrasion this material is curved like this. So it is similar to the sand blasting. And deflation, it is the removal of sand and dust by the wind. See, initially this level was higher and it is getting lowered like this, result in the form of desert pavement. And this is another figure for abrasion and deflation. See, wind charged with sand, they are hitting this rock and in it will get polished like this. In deflation, this is the wind direction and the small particle will be thrown out and only the larger particle will be left out. So it is called as attrition, because abrasion there will be polishing. And sand blasting is similar to abrasion. Deflation I have already told you. So if a particle get wear and tear among themselves, khud mein hi uska ho raha hai, that is attrition. Theek hai? Next is a slope emerging from steep narrow valley into a broader low land, and it is a conical deposit with apex at the mouth of narrow valley. So this is the concept that it has apex at the mouth of narrow valley, so it will be delta. Okay, a stream emerging from a steep narrow valley into broader low land may build up a gently sloping conical deposit with an apex at the mouth of narrow valley. So such a deposit is called as. So here the concept lies in this line that it will be at the mouth of narrow valley. Okay, so it will be alluvial fan. See, this is how it will look. This fan like structure which will be formed at the mouth of valley, it will be called as alluvial fan. Next is Mineral quartz survive as sand grain in beaches, sand dunes, river and soil because we all know that quartz, it has very high resist, it is very resistant to weathering, that it will not get weathered easily. It is shown in the gold is stability series, where we can see olivine, it is least stable, so it get weather very easily, and quartz, it has most stability, so it will get weather in a very difficult way. Okay, answer for 12th will be B, that quartz, it is very resistant to chemical weathering and it crystallizes late according to the Bowman reaction series. है ना, हमने देखा था कि सबसे पहले कौन से मिनरल क्रिस्टलाइज होते हैं, ऑलिवेन, पायरोक्सेन, एम्फीबोल, सबसे लास्ट में क्या होता है, क्वार्ट्ज क्रिस्टलाइज होता है. नेक्स्ट इज द एंगुलर शेयर इन अ डिफॉर्म्ड रॉक बॉडी, इट इज डिफाइंड एज द डिग्री टू विच टू ओरिजिनली परपेंडिकुलर लाइंस आर डिफ्लेक्टेड फ्रॉम 90 डिग्री. एज यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज द एंगुलर स्ट्रेन. Angular strains are slightly more difficult and are measured by the change in the angle between two lines that are initially perpendicular. Okay, so the change in angle, जो change होगा angle का, उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? Angular shear, जिसको हम किसे denote करते हैं? Psi से. And it is more commonly its tangent. So it was initially like this. Okay, and after the deformation, it got deflected in this manner, and this is the angle between them, which is called as angular shear. So angular shear, it is described as the change in angle between two lines that were originally perpendicular to each other. And shear strain, it is the another way to describe this change in angular relationship as the horizontal translation of a line. Okay, this is for the A, this is for B. So next is the appropriate mathematical expression for the total strain in a creep is. So मुझे इसका कुछ material मिला नहीं है, तो मैं इसका answer mark कर देती हूँ as per the solution which I have got. So it is S is equal to A plus B log T plus C T minus T. Okay. Next is class 1 fold. It is distinguished by the dip isogon that converge downward, signifying that the curvature of the outer arc is less than the inner arc. तो हम इसका किससे देखते हैं? इसका concept है Ramsey classification, where dip isogon क्या होता है? It is the line connecting point of identical dip. Okay, so these are called as dip isogons, which connect point of identical dip for vertically oriented folds. So there are three classes: class 1 fold, which is also called parallel fold; class 2 fold; class 3 fold. Okay, so here you can see classification on the base of the dip isogon. So in the case of class 1a, hinge are thinner than the limbs, so this is hinge and these are limbs. Okay, so it is thin than the limbs. And in class 1b, there will be constant thickness. It means if this thickness is a, then this thickness will also be A, this is also A. Okay, so it is also called as parallel fold. Class 1c, here hinge will be thick. Okay, see, this hinge is longer or thicker than the limb. See, this limb is very thin, hai na, patli si hai. Next is class 2 fold. Here the isogons are parallel, it means inside and outside arc it will be identical. Also, it is called as similar fold. Class 3, isogon diverge toward the fold interior and outside arc is tighter. Okay, so this is the important points for the dip isogon of these three folds. Next is throw in a fold is defined as. So throw ko hum kaise define karte hai? See, जो भी ये सेपरेशन होगा, सी इसको कहते हैं हम डिप सेपरेशन. द अमाउंट ऑफ अपेरेंट ऑफसेट ऑफ अ फॉल्टेड सरफेस मेजर्ड इन स्पेसिफाइड डायरेक्शन. सो देयर आर स्ट्राइक सेपरेशन, डिप सेपरेशन एंड नेट सेपरेशन. ओके, एंड आउट ऑफ दीज देयर आर टू टर्म्स, हीव which is this horizontal component, and through this is the vertical component. It contains tip and heave. It contains the strike of the fault. So what is through? It is the thickness of stratigraphic interval between two beds that are brought into contact by the faulting. Okay. 17. Which of the following type of folds are classified on the basis of mechanism of the folding? So it is flexural slip folds. The assembly of tilted blocks, half graben and host is called as, so it is B, pull apart basin landscape. Okay. Next is the value of normal stress and shear stress on each fault plane, which is sigma n, and shear stress sigma s on each fault plane in the Mohr envelope of failure is reflected by. So it is the coordinates of the point making the intersection of each circle with its radius. So this is how it will look. This x-axis will be normal stress. On y-axis, there will be plotting of shear stress. And this is the, in this side, tensional fracturing will occur. And this is the compressional zone. Okay. On the right side will be compression will go on. And in the left side, tension or extension will go on. Okay. Ricke's principle of recrystallization for plastic deformation, it is expressed as, so it is the solution in the pore space of rock dissolve the portion of crystal which is under greater stress. At the same time there is precipitation. ठीक है, जहां पे सबसे ज्यादा stress होगा वहां पे क्या हो जाएगा, dissolution हो जाएगा, है ना, dissolve हो जाएगा. लेकिन जहां पे कम stress होगा वहां पे क्या हो जाएगा, precipitation होगा, deposition होगा. ठीक है. Next is cataclastic flow. It is the result of. So cataclastic flow, it is the result of frictional sliding along the interconnected micro cracks. So here are few terms which I have written. See, cataclastic flow, it is the macroscopic ductile flow as a result of grain scale fracturing and frictional sliding over a band of finite width. Frictional sliding is given. You can read them out for your. For your concern, you can read them out. It is not required right now. Okay. Next is, so this is also I have written from, I think it is taken from the winter book, that cataclastic flow. It is mechanical fragmentation and sliding rotation of fragments. Here, crush, break, bend, grind, undulose, extinction, shedding of micas. These are technically not metamorphic. Next is the outcrop pattern of the bed that tip downstream at an angle less than the gradient of the stream forms a V, which points. So it is related to the rule of V's, which is very important for GATE exam, NET exam, CSIR NET exam, for JAM exam. So you have to remember this, these types, A, B, C, D, F. Okay. So this is, these are the beds, the first case. In which bed dip upstream. Okay, so here bed is dipping upstream. So V, this is the V. So here V will point upstream, blunter than the contours. Okay, and if beds are horizontal, then V point, so V will point upstream parallel to the contour. If bed dip gently downstream, then V will point upstream sharper than the contour. See, kita sharp hai na. If bed dip with stream gradient, see here bed is dipping like this. So there will be no V formation. Koi V nahi ban raha hai. Aise parallel lines ban jayengi. If bed dips steeply downstream, so V will point downstream. If bed dip vertical, then no V will form. See, this horizontal line is forming. No V shape is forming. Okay. So here they are asking from these. It will be for 22. It will be A in upstream direction. In structural contour map, homoclines are distinguished by. So what are homoclines? So it is actually a sequence of strata dipping in the same direction. See, these are dipping in the same direction at a uniform angle. So these are homocline. So these are the subparallel contour line that steadily decrease or increase in elevation across the face of the map. Okay, ठीक है ना, क्योंकि ये क्या है कि एक ही डायरेक्शन में डिप करेंगे, तो ये अगर हम कॉन्टूर मैप में दिखाएंगे तो क्या होगा, सब पैरेलली दिखाएंगे ना. नेक्स्ट इज रेक कैन बी डिफाइंड एज, सो इट इज डिफाइंड एज द एंगल बिटवीन लाइन एंड स्ट्राइक ऑफ द प्लेन विच कंटेन्स दैट लाइन. ठीक है, सो हेयर आर फ्यू टर्म्स फॉर दिस वन. सो इफ यू सी द एटीट्यूड ऑफ लीनियर स्ट्रक्चर, it can be determined by the trend as well as the plunge. So trend, it is the bearing of line, and plunge, it is the inclination or it is the angle of line. Okay, and what are rake and pitch? So it is the acute angle between a line and strike of a plane on which the line lies. Suppose if this is a plane and line is lying on the same plane, so this angle will be rake. Okay, matlab hum koi aur line ko hum ye vertically extend nahi kar rahe ya fir horizontally nahi extend kar rahe, जिस प्लेन पे है उसी पे अगर एक पेन रखा हुआ है तो उसका जो एंगल बनेगा वो हमारा रेक या फिर पिच होगा. ठीक है, तो इसीलिए यहाँ पे बोला विच कंटेन्स दैट लाइन, तो यही कंसेप्ट है इसका. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कोल कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट इज हार्ड कॉम्पैक्ट एंड हैज ग्रेनुलर टेक्सचर, सो इट इज बी ड्यूरेन. फॉर 26, इफ द इंडेसेस ऑफ द एनी क्रिस्टल फेस आर रेशनल नंबर एंड डिटरमाइंड बाय द डिवाइडिंग द इंटरसेप्ट, इट विल बी B. Bauxite, I have told you this in my earlier videos. You can follow that. Okay. It is the gibbsite, diaspore, and bohemite. Next is a few non-metallic minerals are often found associated with ore mineral. Okay. So they are talking about the ore mineral. If this is a rock and it contains ore mineral. Okay. But these have to be separated from the ore before same is processed for the. ठीक है, अब क्या है कि और है बट कुछ नॉन मेटालिक मिनरल्स भी उसके साथ हैं. ठीक है, तो जिसको हम निकालेंगे इससे पहले कि हम उसको और जो रॉक है उसको हम प्रोसेस कर सके किसके एक्सट्रैक्शन के लिए, मेटल की, तो जो चीज हम निकाल देंगे जो अनवांटेड है दैट विल बी गैंग मिनरल्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ग्रुप ऑफ मिनरल आर क्लासिफाइड विद इन द सल्फाइड, तो सल्फाइड कौन से हैं इसमें से. 29 is D, arsenides. Now opal is mineral that displays iridescence or play of color dikhayega when rotated or observed from different direction. It is because, see, this is how it is, because due to the diffraction, the play of color seen in opal is attributed to the diffraction under suitable condition. Okay, so answer will be A. Interference of ray light by minute globule of water trapped in the, because opal it contain silica encountered in the soil dissolved into this water to form silicate rich solution. Opal के formula में हमें क्या है कि water मिलेगा. ठीक है, देखने को तो क्या होगा कि जब ray of light वहां से आएगी तो जो भी water trap होगा ना उसके साथ जो है उसका relation है. Next is pleochroism. So it represent the change of color upon rotation of microscope stage under plane polarization light or PPL. Again, I have told you about this in my earlier videos. You can follow that. And here it is something written for pleochroism. So it is the two extreme in color seen twice during a complete 360 degree rotation. Okay. So for 28, it is. Two extreme of colors seen twice during a complete 360 degree rotation. Next is, in alkali feldspar, a coupled substitution occurs when. So for 32, it is B. That one aluminium ion plus one sodium ion enter in the framework structure and replace one silicon ion. So this is how the couple substitution works. It is the, if ion of different charge substitute, it means that if here you can see it occurs in the plagioclase, here Here you can see it is NaAlSi3O8 and CaAl2Si2O8. So there will be Al3 positive and SiO4. So in couple substitution, what happened? That there will be substitution of Al. It will substitute Si in tetrahedral form. Okay. Next is garnet in situ deposits are generally associated with. So for 33, it is C. They are associated with the metamorphic rocks. Variation in refractive index in Al2SiO5 for polymorph, it is due to the ferric iron and manganese entering structure. The ray velocity surface of anisotropic crystal is an ellipsoid because anisotropic crystal, they transmit light with different velocity in different direction. ठीक, isotropic में आपको क्या होगा कि जो light transmit होगी वो same velocity से होगी. ठीक है, इस but anisotropic में क्या होगा, there will be transmission with different velocity. ठीक है, इसलिए anisotropic में क्या होगा, double refraction हमें देखने को मिलता है. For 36, mineral quartz shows twinning according to Brazil law, Dauphin law, but this twinning is not detectable under the microscope because twin plane is always perpendicular to the twin axis. Or twinning kaun kaun si hai, yeri Brazil twinning, Dauphin twin, Japanese twin. What is Brazil twin? Brazil law, it is a penetration twin that results from the transformation. Dauphin law is also a penetration twin that result from transformation. Japanese law, it is a contact twin. Okay, it is not a penetration one that result from the accident during growth. Next, which basaltic lava enters into water body and it tend to form large sack like bodies. ठीक है, पानी के अंदर ही होगा और लावा निकल रहा है और उसमें क्या है, sack like bodies बन रही है. So it is pillow lava. इग्नेस रॉक फॉर्म बाय द ग्रेविटी सेटलिंग. अब यहाँ पे ग्रेविटी सेटलिंग की ही बात कर लिए तो हम फटाफट जो है क्यूमुलेट टेक्सचर का चूज करेंगे ऑप्शन. नेक्स्ट, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंटेन नियरली इक्वल अमाउंट ऑफ अल्कली फेल्डस्पार प्लेजिक्लेस विद अप्रोक्सीमेटली 10% क्वार्ट्स. सो इट इज बी, क्वार्ट्स मोनजोनाइट. ठीक है, सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम दिस QAPF डायग्राम. Here you will see quartz monzonite. Next is, during fractionation, separated crystal of pyroxene, which is augite, and intermediate plagioclase feldspar form a crystallized rock. So it is known as websterite. So here lies the websterite. Next is, rhyolitic magma tend to rise in dome like bodies, so it is known as diapers. Okay, next is, when cooling of mineralizing liquid is slow, leucite inverts to calcilite K feldspar intergrowth. So this intergrowth is termed as, it is called as pseudoleucite. Next is, in layered intrusion, variation in mineral composition is normally not evident until analysis has been done. So such layering is called as, it is model layering. So it is related to the layered mafic intrusion concepts. So these are few examples or some principle. LMI deposit, Bushveld, Stillwater, very famous, Skagit. These are the location. Bushveld is in South Africa. Stillwater in Montana, USA, and Skagit in East Greenland. And what is layering? It is any sheet like cumulate unit distinguish its by its compositional or textural features. Okay, so it is uniform mineralogically, but and texturally it is homogeneous, it is not heterogeneous. And layering, or you can also say stratification, it can be of model layering, which characterized by variation in relative proportion of constituent minerals, and this is phase clearing. You can read it out if you want to. Cryptic clearing, rhythmic, okay, intermittent. So for 44 question, desilication reaction occurs when the primary alkaline magma generated from primitive subalkaline basaltic magma. Okay. Next is, the magnesium number designated by M is particularly used as, so for 45 it is differentiation index. Nepheline magma crystallizes to form one of the following suit of igneous rock, so it is called as Pigeolite. Which of the following correctly represent the composition of kimberlite? So for kimberlite, you will see one table in the winter book. So there all the rock are written along. So first of all, it is volatile rich, and when you read phlogopite, then you will mark this answer for the kimberlite. Okay, phlogopite dekhte hi aap kimberlite ko tick kar doge, aur volatile rich agar likha hua hai. ऑल्सो पोटासिक अल्ट्रामैफिक रॉक, ठीक है, यही है इसकी डिस्क्रिप्शन. नेक्स्ट इज, ड्यूरिंग रैपिड क्वेंचिंग व्हेन फिनोक्रिस्ट इज सराउंडेड बाय द ग्लास द टेक्सचर इज टर्म्ड एज, सो इट इज विट्रोफाइरिक. ओके, सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज सिमिलर टू स्लेट बट हैज सिल्की शीन ऑन द क्लीवेज सर्फेस, सो इट इज फिलाइट. इट इज लाइक स्लेट ना, ऐसा मीन्स इसकी भी ऐसा दिखेगा आपको कि ये लेयर्स में टूटेगा. If the foliation is caused by the parallel align arrangement of medium to coarse grain, so here they are saying it is medium to coarse grain. Okay, so you will mark schistosity. After reading this only you will mark this one. Okay, ठीक है. ज़्यादा coarse होगा तो क्या होगा? नेइस होगा. और medium to coarse बोला है तो schistosity होगा. With increasing metamorphic intensity, a granuloblastic texture results in, so it will result in the decrease in grain size or loss of fabric. So there is confusion between two of them. You can check this out. Armored relics are, so it is called as minerals as inclusion even though they are no longer present in the rock matrix. ठीक है, पता ये matrix में है नहीं अभी, but still इसकी inclusions present है. So in a snowball crystal, if intensity internal schistosity is undisturbed in the center of porphyroblast but become increasingly tightly folded towards the margin during the formation of granulation cleavage, so this feature represents, so they are talking about the snowball garnet which we read in metamorphic petrology. So this is how it looks, it will look like this, this spiral form, this is snowball garnet. Theek hai, तो ये हमें पता है कि ये सिंटेक्टोनिक इवेंट है. ठीक है, तो ये बस वहीं से ही पूछा हुआ है कि ये ऐसे बनता है, इनिशियली ऐसे होगा, जैसे मेटामॉर्फिज्म बढ़ता जाएगा तो इट विल ग्रो लाइक दिस इनिशियली, और फिर इसकी ऐसे स्पाइरलिंग होती जाएगी और हमें ऐसा देखने को मिलेगा ये ऐसे. नेक्स्ट इज, इन मेटामॉर्फिक रॉक when all grains of same size have planar boundaries which are intersecting at approximately 120 degree, then the texture is known as, so it is granuloblastic texture, jisme 120 degree angle dekha hua hai. To ye winter book mein seedha hi likha hua hai, in sab ki texture ki definition wahi se dekh sakte ho. See, this is granuloblastic and this is dacite. Next is, in a zoned olivine crystal, iron tend to diffuse away from a ferrite parts and rich in phosphorite, while magnesium will tend to diffuse in opposite direction. So this diffusion is known as, so it is flux diffusion. Okay, for 56, which of the following is defined a line joining point where rock have suffered metamorphism under similar pressure temperature condition, so it is isocrat. And eclogite, what is eclogite? So it is red and green dense rock dominated by garnet एंड ऑम्फेसाइट। ठीक है, ऑम्फेसाइट पढ़ते ही आप एक्लोगाइट को मार्क करोगे। नेक्स्ट इज द ग्रेनोलाइट फेशियस रॉक दैट आर एट हाई ग्रेड डेवलप फेल्सिक सेग्रीगेशन ड्यू टू पार्शियल मेल्टिंग आर कॉल्ड एज, सो दीज आर मिग्मेटाइट्स, है ना। इसमें क्या होगा कि सेग्रीगेशन हो जाती है फेल्सिक की और मैफिक की। नेक्स्ट इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्रेनुलाइट फेशियस, इट इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ बोथ सीपीएक्स एंड ओपीएक्स कॉमनली विथ क्वार्ट्ज एंड प्लेजोपेस। ठीक है, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रिप्रेजेंट द लोकेशन ऑफ मेटामॉर्फिक पेयर्ड बेल्ट, सो हियर समथिंग इज रिटन अबाउट PMB और पेयर्ड मेटामॉर्फिक बेल्ट। सो दीज आर सेट ऑफ पैरेलल लीनियर रॉक यूनिट्स दैट डिस्प्ले कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग मेटामॉर्फिक मिनरल असेंबलेज। ओके, एंड दे आर डेवलपिंग एट द कन्वर्जन प्लेन पे मिलेगा जहां पे सबडक्शन एक्टिव होगा। ठीक है, और क्या होगा कि यहाँ पे लो टेम्परेचर हाई प्रेशर होगा एंड अनदर कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द हाई टेम्परेचर लो प्रेशर। ठीक है, दो प्लेट्स होंगी, एक में एक बेल्ट में क्या होगा कि लो टेम्परेचर हाई प्रेशर होगा, दूसरी बेल्ट में क्या होगा हाई टेम्परेचर लो प्रेशर होगा। ठीक है, इसलिए पेयर बोल रहे हैं ना, तो ये हमें काम अलोंग द मोबाइल बेल्ट्स। ओके, नेक्स्ट इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज अ वैरायटी ऑफ सैंडस्टोन दैट इज एक्सेप्शनली रिच इन माइका डिस्पर्स इन पैलरल और सब पैलरल लेयर्स। ठीक है, ऐसा कौन सा सैंडस्टोन है जिसमें माइका मिलेगा, सो इट इज गिनेस्टर। नेक्स्ट इज अ मडी लैमिनेटेड एंड फिजाइल रॉक कैपेबल ऑफ ब्रेकिंग इनटू स्मॉल फ्लेक्स इज कॉल्ड एज, सो इट इज शेल। Which of the following explain the chelation process of weathering? So it is bonding of metal ion to organic substance to form organic molecule and removal of cations from mineral lattice, keeping the cations in solution. Next is on account of the charged surface of clay mineral, their interaction with saline water leads to the clumping in aggregate of randomly oriented clay flakes. So this process is termed as, this is flocculation. नेक्स्ट इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बेड इज मार्क्ड बाय रफ और ट्रफ और स्कूप शेप। ठीक है, ऐसा स्कूप शेप होगा या फिर ट्रफ जैसा होगा, तो ये क्या है, लेंटिकुलर बेडिंग। नेक्स्ट इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज ग्रेन सपोर्टेड लाइमस्टोन दैट कंटेन्स अ मिक्राइट मड मैट्रिक्स, इज पैकस्टोन। सो ड्यूरिंग डायजेनेसिस द प्रोसेस ऑफ इंट्रास्ट्रेटल सोल्यूशन लीड्स टू द dissolution of one mineral and precipitation of the mineral simultaneously. Which of the following rock type may also be formed along the planes of movement in the crust? So it is C, breccia. ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्या कहीं पे movement हो रही है तो क्या होगा, breccia, फिर fault, gouge ऐसा बनता है ना। Now rip current that occur near beach are localized in nature. These move seaward as narrow नियर सरफेस करंट, तो ये है रिप करंट, सेंटर में ऐसे नैरो पोर्शन है, दिस इज रिप करंट। ठीक है, इसमें अगर कोई फंसेगा तो वो बहता ही चला जाएगा, रिप करंट्स के बीच में अगर कोई फंस जाएगा। नेक्स्ट इज द रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ डोलोमाइट रॉम्स बाय कैल्साइट इज टर्म्ड एज, For 71 it is dolomitization. The Dead Sea provides most modern evaporite deposit of the marine subcast. ठीक है, the organism is decomposed and loses its nitrogen oxygen volatile constituent. So this process is known as carbonization. The study of process of fossilization. So it is taphonomy. Next is the paratype is a specimen other than the holotype which is formally designated by the author of as a species as 475 it is A, having been used in the description of the species. For 76 it is B, for 77 it is A, that length is defined as the maximum linear dimension in anterior posterior direction and height kya hogi perpendicular to length. See, this is height, okay, and this is length. So length is along the anterior posterior direction and height is along the dorsal ventrals. Okay, so this is what they have given over here. Next, the body part in which invertebrate can be transversely, longitudinally can be divided into three parts. So for 78, it is trilobites. Brain size for this one is 2/3 of the body size. For 80, missing link ki agar baat kare, humans or ape-like ancestors ki, so it will be Homo erectus या फिर Homo habilis, इन दोनों के बीच में है, इसका मुझे इतना श्योर नहीं, आप देख लेना. The genus Orohippus, which represent the second stage in the evolution of horse, is popularly known as, for 8, it is mountain horse, ठीक है? Oro itself indicates mountain. Large benthic foraminifera became abundant in diversity and quantity since, for 82, it is B. Which of the following plant fossil exhibit lanceolate pinnules type leaf with prominent midrib and wings? So it is Glossopteris. So the following foramen fossil is found in the Ladakh and Kashmir. So it is. Okay. So for 85, they are saying there is one fossil which is Protactus. It is, we are getting it in सॉल्ट रेंज इन पाकिस्तान. और दूसरा क्या है, प्रोडक्टस शेल, जो कि हमें कहाँ मिल रहा है, स्पीति एरिया में. और वो बोल रहे कि ये दोनों लिथोलॉजिकली डिफरेंट है और सेम एज के हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि बोथ ऑफ द रॉक फॉर्मेशन वर डिपॉजिटेड एट डिफरेंट सेडिमेंट्री बेसिन. ये दोनों अलग बेसिन है ना, पाकिस्तान का अलग है, स्पीति एरिया का अलग है. तो ये इसका रीजन होगा. सेकेंड, इन स्टेटिग्राफिक कोरिलेशन द टर्म होमोटेक्सियल रेफर टू द फॉर्मेशन. So for 86, it is D, bearing same fossil content despite in different time. The Shingum shear zone, it is also known as. So for 87, it is Shingum copper belt के लिए. Copper मिलता है ना वहाँ पे हमें. The stratigraphic boundary demarcating Archean of close bed granite. तो इसका क्या होगा? Eparchean unconformity. The sediment of the Dharwar supergroup were deposited over a basement of. So Dharwar किसके ऊपर डिपॉजिट हुए पड़े, तो मेटामॉर्फिक्स हैं, है ना. तो इट इज शिरगुर शिष्ट एंड पीजीसी. द चिपलीगाड ग्रुप, इट कंप्राइजेस ऑफ ह्यूज थिकनेस ऑफ फिलाइट स्लेट एंड माइकाशेस. वेम्पल्ले शेल एंड लाइमस्टोन, दे बिलोंग टू पापागनी ग्रुप. तो ये कुडप्पा सुपर ग्रुप पे आपको याद करना पड़ेगा, ठीक है. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग is the characteristic feature of extrusive and intrusive phase of the Malani igneous suit. Okay, so for 92, it is B. It represents one of the world largest example of felsic magmatism. The oldest group of Kudappa supergroup is, so it is first one, Papagani group. The Cretaceous rock exposed along the southern slope of the Shillong plateau have been grouped into. सो शिलोंग प्लेट्यू में हमें क्या मिलेगा, दिस महादेव फॉर्मेशन, ठीक है. द वर्ल्ड वाइड ओरिजिनिक इवेंट विच टुक प्लेस ड्यूरिंग ऑर्डोविशियन एंड साइलूरियन पीरियड, सो इट इज नोन एज. तो ये ओरिजिनिस का क्वेश्चन है, तो ये तो फैक्चुअल है, ये याद करना पड़ेगा आपको. सो इट इज कैलिडोनियन ओरिजिनी. द लीनियर ऑफिलेटिक बेल्ट ऑफ लद्दाख वॉज फॉर्म एज अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द एम्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ बेसिक वोल्केनिक इन एसोसिएशन विद डीप मरीन सेडिमेंट. Which of the following process is most commonly associated with the fumaroles? So it is sublimation. Which of the following is commonly known as the black lead but lacks lead in its composition? So it is graphite. Which of the following mineral is used in important raw material for the manufacture of cement fertilizer? It is gypsum. For 100, which of the following ore mineral is associated with Nepheline cyanide in Khamman district of Andhra Pradesh? So for 100, it is corundum. B. Okay. Which silicate of iron and magnesium is termed as chrysolite? So for 101, it is B, olivine. Which of the following statement regarding hydrothermal solution is correct? So it is D, that they are concentrated, weakly dissociated, and electrolytic solution. So the following are example of latrabeneite type deposit. So it is magnesite deposit of Mysore, Karnataka. The host of mineral deposit occur in the contact zone of meso and epizonal igneous plutons because these are weak zone, mixing of fluid take place and thermal gradient is steep. Which of the following is correct for the bituminous coal? So it is B. For 106, the organic theory of oil genesis appeared in the first time. So it is B. For 107, it is A. For 108, it is D. For 109, इट इज बी. ठीक है, कोलेसेंस क्या होता है कि छोटे छोटे ड्रॉप मिलके जो है जुड़ जाते हैं और वो इनिशियली अल्टीमेटली क्या है, एक बड़ा ड्रॉप बन जाएगा ना सब मिलके. 1010 का क्या है? बी. 1011, सी. 1012 का ए. 1013 का डी. ठीक है, 1014 का ए, 1015 का 116, इट इज सी. फॉर 117, इट इज ए. फॉर 118, इट इज ए. फॉर 119, इट इज ए. फॉर 120, इट इज ए. ओके, सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस चैनल. डू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब. See you in next video. Bye-bye.